Hi children, welcome to Educa. Today we are with a new video. This is the third part of Unit 9, Human Organ Systems. So, today our subtopic is Human Skin. This is a diagram of human skin. Skin is the largest organ of the body. It weighs about 4.5 kg and 1 to 2 millimeter thick in an adult. Skin is mainly consist of two layers. They are epidermis and dermis. This diagram shows you the layers of epidermis and dermis of the skin. Now you have to study about the structure of human skin. This diagram shows you a structure of human skin. Observe it carefully. At the top of the figure, there's a hair stem. Here are erector muscles also there. Here are follicle, capillaries, nerve end, sweat glands, epidermis, and sebaceous glands are there. Look at the parts of epidermis and what are the parts contains to dermis. Now we have to study about epidermis. This figure is relevant for epidermis. The outermost layer of the skin is epidermis. The epidermis is made up of several layers of cells. The epidermis is heeding thousands of dead cells and replenishing daily. Skin color is due to melanin, a pigment produced in the epidermis to protect from the sun's ultraviolet rays. This figure shows you dermis. The dermis beneath the epidermis contains hair follicles, sweat gland, sebaceous glands, muscles, nerve ending and blood vessels, that means capillaries, we can observe in dermis. The dermis is thicker than the epidermis. Hypodermis lies beneath the dermis. Let's discuss about the functions of human skin. First one is protective layer of the body. The layers of the epidermis minimize the water loss from the body and prevent from the dehydration. Melanin pigment in the cells of the skin protects the body from ultraviolet rays. The secretion of sebaceous gland acts as the barrier against the microorganism infection. This is a natural defense mechanism. Now you can see how the skin acts as a natural defense mechanism. Next one is regulation of body temperature. When a temperature increases in the environment than the body temperature, the sweat glands secrete sweat to release heat. When the atmospheric temperature is lower than the body temperature, the blood supply to the surface of the skin is decreased and the body temperature is regulated. The secretion of sweat is minimized. Now you can see how it's happened. Decreasing and increasing of body temperature. Next function is acting as a sensory organ. In the dermis, there are nerve endings. In the dermis, there are nerve endings which detect the pressure, touch, and temperature. Now you can see this figure shows you how the skin acts as a sensory organ. Synthesis of vitamin D. Using the energy of sunlight, vitamin D is synthesized in the cells of the skin. Now you can see this figure shows you how skin synthesizes vitamin D using sunlight. Next function is excretion. The sweat glands excrete sweat which consists of urea, uric acid and ammonium salts. Therefore, skin can be considered as an excretory organ. As the skin is exposed to the environment, there is a possibility to the skin to be infected by microorganisms and waste materials. So, wipe your face with tissue paper. You will notice that your face becomes clean and there is dust in the tissue paper. Cleanliness and protection helps to maintain a healthy skin. Let's see some tips that helps to maintain a healthy skin. Have a nutritive diet. Vitamin A and vitamin E are essential for healthy skin. Consuming fresh fruits and vegetables helps to supply vitamin A and E to the skin. Drink adequate amount of fresh water daily. Be gentle to your skin. But daily if the person is not sick. Use a mild soap which does not wipe the oil on your skin. After wash or bath, gently bathe the skin with a towel and do not rub against the skin. Protection of sun. If you are exposing to sun for a long period of time, wear clothes that covers your skin well. Avoid smoking and smokers. Smoking narrows the blood vessels in the skin and reduces the circulation of blood. The skin cells get less oxygen and nutrients. Therefore, the skin loses its strength and elasticity and develops wrinkles and looks older. Let's discuss about some other factors. Wearing cotton dresses. Do not share your dresses with others. These tips are very essential for keep your healthy skin. Get medical advices for skin disorders such as pimples and warts. Manage stress and always try to maintain good health, good mental health. Thank you. Let's meet with next lesson, electricity.